Good morning, students. Welcome to the next class. So today we are going to discuss one practical problem. So in the offline classes, we have done almost all the practical exercises, but one exercise is left out, that is the last one, correlation ratio, computation of correlation ratio. This one we didn't discuss in our theory class also. We have done the theory part, but the problem we didn't do actually. So now we'll discuss a last practical, that is computation of correlation ratio. I've already given you the record and said you to write the record. So in that, the last practical exercise 12 is computation of correlation ratio. What is correlation ratio? So we have different types of correlations, right? Karl-Pearson correlation coefficient, rank correlation. So like that, different correlations we have. So what is the difference between Karl-Pearson correlation coefficient and correlation ratio? Coming to Karl-Pearson correlation coefficient, it studies the linear relationship between the two variables. Whenever you have the two random variables, the linear relationship between those two variables can be studied or measured by using Karl-Pearson correlation coefficient. Suppose if you have a curvy linear relationship. Suppose if you have a curvy linear relationship like this. For example, in the class we have discussed that growth of the human body with respect to the age. So at the certain age, at the childhood also, the growth will be very high for the human body. Whereas when it comes to a particular age, that is around 30 years, the growth will be settled down. It will not grow much. The human body doesn't grow much, but it settles at certain point. And after the certain point, that is after 40s, the growth gradually decreases. So if you consider this example, it will be having a curvilinear relationship between the variables. So if I consider the human body growth and the age on x-axis and growth on y-axis, I will be getting a curvilinear relationship like this. So study the curvilinear like this, we use the concept of correlation ratio. So first write down the age. So here the question is given, obtain the correlation ratio of y on x. So remember, correlation ratio is denoted by mean term. If you are finding the relation of y on x, it is denoted by eta yx square. The value of eta yx square formula will be writing. So, coming to the question, obtain the correlation ratio of y on x to the following data. So, what is the data is given? Here x values and y values are given. The different x values are 10, 15, 20, 25. And different y values are 7, 9, 11, 13, and 15. And the corresponding frequencies are given. So these are the frequencies, Fij's values. These are the y values, yij values, these are the xi values. These are the xi values, these are the yij values corresponding to the frequencies Fij. So frequencies are 3, 2, this is empty, 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 1, 4, 6, this is empty, 3, 4, 2, 2, 1, 5, MD, MD, 6, dash, 1. So this is the question. First we write down the aim. So write down the aim. What will be writing the aim? The aim is to calculate the correlation ratio. Y on x, that is eta by x, to the given data. Now we write the formula and procedure. Write stepwise, same in the record. Formula and procedure. So in the formula and procedure, write down the correlation ratio formula first and describe that. So the correlation ratio is given as correlation ratio of y on x is given as eta yx is equals to, the formula is eta yx square equals to summation over I ti squared by ni minus t squared by n divided by summation over I nj into yj squared minus t squared by n. So this is a formula for the correlation ratio, which can be also written as this formula. We have simplified and written the simplified formula in our theory class. So we use the same formula, simplified one, that is summation always I will be ranging from I equals to 1 to m t I square by n I minus t square by n divided by, this term is nothing but the frequencies included here, that is double summation over I equals to 1 to n, j equals to 1 to n. This can be written as Fij into pi ij square minus t square by n. So whereas this t square by n is called as the correction factor. If you remember the theory class, and it will be easy for you to understand. So here, what is t square? T square is the total. So to get the total, first we write the t I dot. You can write this t I or t I dot, both are the same. So when t I is summation over I equals to 1 to n f I j into y I j. That means you will be multiplying the frequencies f I j with y I j values. There we have the y I j values. If you multiply with f I j, then we get the total. 7 into 3 plus 7 into 2 will be your first value. So like that, if you consider the total of that one, we get the t I dot. Similarly, what is t? T is the total of all the values. That is, if you consider summation over I equals to 1 to n, t I, summation of all these values, we get the grand total, that is t. So here n I indicates the, what is n I? That is the number of values. So each set, how many values we have, that is indicated by n I. You can write n I dot or n I, both the same. T I dot or t I is also same. N I dot is nothing but the total of the frequencies. So summation over j, the total of the frequencies f I j will give you the n I value. Suppose here you are having 3, here you are having 2. So 3 plus 2, 5 will be your total, that is n I dot. Similarly, t I have given this formula, or even if you add all the values also, you get the same thing. All the values multiplied with yij, or frequencies multiplied with yij, you get the same value. So what is capital N? Capital N is the total of all the frequencies, that is double summation over fij, that is double summation over I and j, fij will be your capital N value. So these are the required values we need for calculating the eta yx square. Now we'll see the calculation part. So this is formula and procedure. Now we'll do the calculation part.
Y values. So what are the x values? 10,
16, 20 and 25. So what are the different y values? 7, 9, 11, 13 and last 15. So next after that, write down all the frequencies given, that is here 3, 2 and these 2 are empty. Mean this is empty, 1, 4, 6, next empty, 3, 4, 2, next is 2, 1, 5, empty and empty, 6, dash and 1. So these are the values given in the question. So first what we have to find? First, we will find the totals, that is n I dot and n dot j. So, no need of finding n dot j because we are finding only the correlation ratio of y on x. If you are finding x on y, then you will be finding it. So, first, want n I dot. So, n I dot means it is the column totals. I values you are taking the number of total I values. So, I means it is the totals of x. X are here, so the column totals will be nothing but n I dot. So add on the frequency. You have 3 plus 2 is 5. Next, 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 6 is 12, 13. Next, 4 plus 4 is 6. 4 plus 4 is 8. 8 plus 5 is. Next, 6 plus 2 is. A plus 1 is 9. Now we got the n I dot values. So after getting n I dot values, next what we have to find? T I dot. So what is T I dot formula? Summation over j equals to 1 to n f I j into y I j. So you want T I j values. So below n I dot you find T I dot values also by using the formula. So what is the formula? Summation over j equals to n fij into yij. So these are the yij values. 7, 9, 11, 13, 15 are the yi values, yij values. Fij means the frequencies. So we need to add it. We need to first multiply it and add. So wherever you have the values, there only will be multiplied. So first what you have here? Fij into yij, right? So 7 into 3, 7 3s are 21 plus, so first value you get 21 plus second value 13 into 2. So 13 into 2 is 26. So overall you will get here the value, the first value is 47. So what you are doing in T I dot, you will be multiplying Fij's and Yij's and adding those values. Similarly, you will be adding these two. 7 2s are 14 plus 9 1s are 9. 14 plus 9 is 23. 23 plus 11 into 3. So 11 3s are 33. 33 plus 13 into 1 is 13 plus 15 into 6. Take your calculators and solve it. You will get, add all those values. So first is 7 into 3. 7 2s are 14 plus 9 1s are 9 plus 11 3s are 33 plus 13 1s are 13 plus 15 6. 15 into 6. Total you will get the answer as 159. So this value is 159. So similarly next value, so where you have the values multiplied only there, first 9 into 4 plus next 11 into 4, 11 into 4 plus next is 13 into 5. So you will get the answer as 145. And the last value you need to find is 9 into 6 plus 11 into 2 summation and n dot j summations. So I am finding n dot j also. So add row wise totals. 3 plus 2 is 5. 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 plus 6 is 11. 3 plus 4 is 7. 7 plus 2 is 9. 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 plus 5 is 8. 6 plus 1 is 7. So add all those values. Even if you add row wise or even if you add column wise, you will get the same answer, that is n equals to 40. So this is your n value and this is the summation over I equals to 1 to, sorry, j equals to 1 to n t I dot. This is summation t I dot j. But we want summation t I dot square by n I. So you will take no need of this total. Find the next column. So next, what I want? See, summation of t I dot square, t I dot square by n I dot. So find that one, t I dot square by n I dot. Already you have ti values, so ti values square it and divide with ni dot. So first, 47 square divided by, what is ni dot? 5. It is 441.8. So this is the first value.
Last is 15 square into 6.
be getting the answer as 2061. And the last one, the third one is, here you don't have the value, here 9 square into 4 plus, next is 11 square into 4 plus, next one is 13 square into 5. So the answer is 165. Sorry, the answer is yes, 1653. The answer is 1653. Next, the last column, that is 9 square into 6 plus, next is 11 square into 2 plus 15 square into 1, that is 15 square only, you will get 953. Now we got all these values, right? Add all these values, that is the last column, you will get the summation of, here you will get, so the summation, double summation, Fij into Yij squared. So add all those values, you will get 485 plus 2061 plus 1653. Plus 953. So answer is 5152. 5152. So this one, now we got it, we got all the values. Ti dot square by ni dot, you got the summation. So you didn't do the summation, right? So add all those values, you will get the answer as 4923.9111. 923.9. So you got all the values and we have capital T. So what is capital T value? Capital T is the total of Ti dot. So add Ti dot values, that is 47 plus 159 plus 145 plus 91. So that is 442. So here you get capital T 442. So this is capital T value. So similarly, how we have done ni dot method only, n dot g also we did to verify whether the row total or column total both should be equal. So here I am doing ti dot to find capital T. You can also do t dot j also. So how we do t dot j? So t dot j formula is, since it is j, we will take summation. Same formula, Fij into Yij. Here we have done column wise, here we will be doing row wise. So how we will do 7 into 3 plus 7 into 2? You will get the first one. Similarly, 9 into 1 plus 9 into 4 plus 9 into 6. You will get the next answer. So do this one as a homework and check whether the total, whatever the total you are getting, that should be equals to 440. So try to do this, that is Ti dot. So now whatever the values we got, we will substitute all those values in our required formula to get the theta square yx. Now find the value of theta square yx. Write down the formula, theta yx square equals to summation over I equals to 1 to n Ti dot by ni dot minus t square by n divided by double summation I equals to 1 to n, j equals to 1 to n, Fij into yi. that is the last column total, that is 5152. So you get 5152 minus the same t square by n, that is 442 square divided by 40. So find out this answer. So first you know 442 square divided by 40, you will get that answer as 4884. So neta square yx equals to 0.1486. So we want neta yx. So apply root to it, which implies neta yx equals to square root of 0.1486. So apply square root of that answer is. So therefore, neta yx equals 5. So this is the procedure for finding the correlation ratio. So first, for the given question, write down the formula. If it is neta yx, you will get this formula. If it is neta xy, instead of this value, that is summation I equals to 1 to m, ti dot by ni dot, you will get the value. That means you have to find the value t dot j by n dot t dot j square by n dot j. So how we find similarly here we have done column wise. Here we will do the row wise. So I will give you the homework while sending the notes. I will give a problem. You check for the neta xy also. For the same, at least for the same problem, you try to do. You try to do that. You find the t dot j value and next you find t dot j square by n dot j. Whatever the total you get, that total will be equal to this total. That is 4. Sorry, not that total. This total will be equal. This will be, you will be getting a different value. And even if you find, so if you do neta xy, you will be finding the fij into yij square. Right? Here also we are finding. It's the same formula, but here we are doing column wise. Here we will be doing the row wise. But the answer will be same. Whatever the total you will get here, that will be same, that is 515. So once check, I have done neta yx square. For the same problem, you try to do neta xy also. So once I will revise this problem, see, first you write x values, y values, and the corresponding frequencies as well. Next, what you will find? Ni dot and n dot g. So ni dot means the total of column frequencies, n dot j means the total of row frequencies. After that, you will be finding the value for ti dot. What is ti dot? Ti dot formula is summation over j equals to 1 to n fij into yij. So you will multiply frequencies and yij values. These are the frequencies, these are the yij values. So 7 into 3 plus 13 into 2, you will get the ti dot value. Similarly, t dot j means you will do row wise, that is 7 into 3 plus 7 into 2, only two values, so you will get it. So try to do this one. and find out the neta xy square value also. So next is ti dot square. Already you got ti dot square it and divide it with the before values, that is ni dot. Coming to fij into yij square, here we are taking only yij, but here we will take the squares. So 7 square into 3 plus 13 square into 2. So similarly for all the columns you will be finding this, but if you want row wise, you will be taking 7 square into 3 plus 7 square into 2. So next means 9 square into 1 plus 9 square into 4 plus 9 square into 6, like that. So complete the problem and find out the neta xy square value. Similarly, how I did the neta yx square. So I said you to solve the problem for the neta xy. So I have given the value for neta yx. So you need to find neta xy. For that you need the columns t dot j square by n dot j. So what is t dot j? I have already solved before only. So here we have n dot j values also. Square these values, that is 35 square divided by 5, we get 245. So similarly, for solve for all the values, next I want is fij into yij square. So here also we have got fij into yij square. This total and this total will be same, that is 5152. Here we are doing column wise, but here we will be doing the row. Simply you can multiply, it is square, so 7 square into you can do n dot j, or you can multiply the single terms also. So for easy calculations we will be doing 7 square, that is 49 into n dot j 5, you will get 245. So similarly solve all those and substitute those values in the neta xy formula. So here the formula changes. So what is the formula for neta xy square? In place of ti dot, we will get t dot j. And whenever we have t dot j, we will take summation over j equals to 1 to n t dot j square by n dot j minus, this will be constant, that is t square by n divided by double summation I equals to 1 to n j equals to 1 to n fij into yij square minus t square by n. So substitute all those values, whatever we got in that. After substituting, you will get neta xy square value as 1. So this implies that neta xy equals to 1. So if you observe, the maximum limit for correlation ratio is 1. That means your answer is correct only. If your answer goes below 0 or above 1, that means there are the calculation mistakes in your problem. So this is the problem for correlation ratio. Copy this problem and try to solve all the values. Check the values. If you have any doubts, we will be clarifying it in the online class. So our online class is on Saturday. On every Saturday, we will be having the live session. In that live class, we will be discussing our doubts.